because since this beam is actually, I can just show you. Yeah, now you can see here. Now, since this beam, there are two possibilities. Either you can take reaction as the redundant, or you can take moment as the redundant. Now, I will tell you what happens if you take reaction as the redundant, right? So if you take reaction as the redundant, you have to remove B and C, right? So then if you remove roller supports at B and C, this beam is actually having, after that, the beam becomes determinate. Now you can see the beam is actually having a UDL for this much span, and we have a point load here, and we have a UDL for this much span. Now you can imagine, when you remove the roller supports at B and C by considering reaction as the redundant, now you have a simply supported beam with the pin support at A and roller support at D. Now you can see there are different types of loading. Some patch is having UDL here, and some is having UDL here, and one concentrated load is here. So drawing the bending moment diagram becomes really difficult for you. Actually, it is not so difficult. It is easy, but the shape will become very uneven. So the conjugate beam will have very uneven shape, and your calculations will increase a lot. So for that purpose, if you take moment as a redundant, you can see here, we have simple bending moment diagrams, which we can easily use and do our further calculations to get the slope at B and C. Right? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So just imagine, if by taking reaction in this numerical example, your bending moment diagram will be complicated one. So the further calculations will be not so easy. Okay, it will be little difficult. So for that purpose, we are actually taking moment as a redundant. And I must tell you, in most of the numerical examples which will be solved using flexibility matrix method, we usually take moment as a redundant and not the reaction as a redundant. Yes, you can take reaction as a redundant when you take out reaction as a redundant, maybe something like this in this numerical example, if you see. Okay, in this numerical example, if you see, if you take reaction as a redundant, your bending moment diagram will be very easy to draw. So for that purpose, we can take reaction as a redundant. But in these type of numerical examples, it is always better to take moment as the redundant, right? So what we did here, you calculated the statical indeterminacy. We took moment at B and C as the redundant by introducing a hinge at B and C. Now by introducing a hinge at B and C, our beam became, these spans became independent, and they are acting as if they are independent simply supported beams. So I was able to draw these bending moment diagrams and the M by EI diagrams because I need to use conjugate beam method. Now, since you are taking moment as a redundant, I told you, you should actually calculate slope. If you take reaction as the redundant, you should actually calculate the deflection. Now, here I'm taking moment as the redundant, so you need to calculate the slope at B and C. Now, you can see point B is common to span AB and span BC, both. So, for span AB, you need to calculate the slope at B, and for span BC, you need to calculate slope at B, and if you add them, you'll get the total slope at B. Now, the similar thing happens at point C also. Now for that purpose, I have taken span AB separate here, BC and CD separate here, and I have drawn the conjugate beams. Since I need to calculate slope on the real beam, I need to calculate the shear force on the corresponding point on the conjugate beam. So shear force at point B is nothing but the reaction. So for this beam, the reaction at B is nothing but this total load divided by 2. Now for this beam, reaction at B is nothing but not total load divided by 2, it is actually the reaction at B, which you can easily calculate, right? So this is how I have calculated BY1 and BY2 and have added them together to get the total slope at point B. So is there any problem up to this point? Students, do you have any difficulties till this point? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You don't have any difficulties till this point. Shall I proceed next?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Now we actually need to calculate slope at B and C both. Okay. But I have calculated only at slope at B. I also need to calculate what is the slope at C. So let us do that. So let me just write that. how I have written here, that is slope at B on real beam is equal to shear force at B on conjugate beam, which is equal to shear force at B on the conjugate beam. So I will take the same point. So instead of B, I will replace it by C, right? Okay, it is not now slope at B, instead it is slope at C now. Okay, slope at C on real beam is equal to shear force at C on conjugate beam, which is actually equal to reaction at C on conjugate beam. So now I need to calculate what is the total reaction at point C on the conjugate beam. So I have to use this figure and I have to use this figure. So let me just mark them. Let this reaction be CY1 and let this reaction be CY2. So I need to calculate both CY1 and CY2, right? So I'll mark here itself. That is, this is actually CY1. So I need to calculate CY1 also. So since I know BY2, I can calculate CY1. How I can calculate CY1? Because I know BY2. How can I do that quickly? Which equilibrium equation I can apply? Which equilibrium equation I can apply?
Can I apply?
Yeah, correct. Summation of Fy equal to 0, taking all the forces in the upward direction as positive, right? So By2 is actually downwards, so I will write it as minus 1680 divided by EI, because I have already calculated By2, right? And this is upwards, this totally uniformly varying load is upwards, so I will write it as plus. Okay, I will take this part separately first, half of base is 4 and height is 360 by EI, and this part separately plus half of base is 12 and height is once again 360 by EI. Okay, so no any other points are there. Yeah, of course, this CY1 is downwards, so I will write it as minus CY1 equal to 0. Now I can easily calculate CY1. Okay, so let me just do that. How much I will get CY1? Let me calculate that. Okay, so I will write minus 1680 divided by EI, right? Plus, so this will come out to be 0.5 into 4 into 360 plus 720 by EI. And this part comes out to be 0.5 into 12 into 360, 2160 by EI. Minus CY1 equal to 0. So minus 1680, minus 1680 plus 720 plus 2160. 2160. So this comes out to be 1200. So if I take it on right hand side, I will get CY1 as 1200 divided by EI. Is that okay, students? CY1 calculation. CY1, I'm getting 1200 divided by EI. Now I will take this one because I need to calculate CY2 also. So let me draw that. So this is actually roller support. This is also a roller support. This is 12 meters. point C and point D. This is a parabolic distribution and the load is actually upwards. So how much is the value? Yeah, 360 by EI. Let me mark them. This I want actually CY2. Okay, CY2 I want. So for that I can take the total load divided by 2 is nothing but CY2 in this case. So CY2 is equal to the total load is 2/3 of base is 12 and height is 360 divided by EI. This is actually the total load. So this divided by 2, you will get CY2. So CY2, you are getting 2/3 of 12, 2/3 of 12 into 360 into 0.5. So you will get 1440 by EI. Okay, so I actually want slope at C, right? Because theta C is nothing but CY1 plus CY2. So I can write theta C as, that is 1200 plus 1440, right? 1200 plus 1440. I'm getting 2640 by EI. Are you clear, students? Is that okay? Any doubts are there?
No, sir.
No, right? Okay. What I will do, I will give some different notations here, full different notations. So instead of theta B, let me call it as theta B naught. And instead of theta C, I will call it as theta C naught, right? I will tell you why I made some change in the notations. Okay, so this is your third step wherein you have to actually you have taken the moment as the redundant at B and C by introducing the hinges at B and C, and you have calculated the slope at B and C. Why you calculated the slope at B and C? Because you have taken moment as the redundant. So this is your one step. Now in the next steps, what you have to do, so I will to correlate that, I will take this numerical example which I did previously by taking reaction as the redundant, right? So what we did in this numerical example, we took reaction as the redundant in this numerical example. So we removed those roller supports, we calculated the deflection at 1 and 2. So in our numerical example, that is in this present example, we calculated the slope at B and C, right? Then what we did in this numerical example, next step is, right, you can just see here. Okay, now at this point I applied 1 kilonewton unit load and I calculated the deflection at 1 and 2. Next, what I did, I applied 1 kilonewton at this point and calculated the deflections at 1 and 2, right? Okay, so totally 6 deflection values I got. So what are those 6 deflection values? These 2 deflection values because of the external load, 2 deflection values because of applying 1 kilonewton at this point, and 2 deflection values because of applying 1 kilonewton at this point, right? So totally 6 deflection values I got, and I framed this flexibility matrix equation to get these reactions, that is unknown reactions CY and BI. These are actually the redundants, right? Now I will come back to this numerical example. Okay, since I'm taking moment as the redundant, okay, when I took reaction as the redundant, I applied 1 kilonewton at the particular points. Here I am taking moment as the redundant. Okay, now can anybody tell me what I have to apply here at B and C? Should I apply 1 kilonewton load or what? Have you understood my question, students? When I took reaction as the redundant, I applied 1 kilonewton load, right? But here I am taking moment as the redundant. So what should I apply? Can anybody just guess? Of course, I will not apply 1 kilonewton force, but what can I apply?
1 kilonewton moment.
Yes, what you told? 1 kilonewton meter? Moment. Come on, go ahead. Yes, correct. Instead of applying 1 kilonewton force, I have to actually apply 1 kilonewton meter moment. Did you got, students? Right, so let me just write down that point also here. Okay, when you take when you take reaction as a redundant, okay, so you have to actually apply force. Okay, but when you take moment as a redundant, moment. Force unit and moment unit. Is that clear, students? Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So now, how will you apply that? Because this point B is common for span AB also and for span BC also. So, as simple as that, 1 kilonewton meter moment you apply at point B in span AB. At the same time, you apply 1 kilonewton meter moment at point B in span BC. That's it. Okay, so like that, we can apply that. And always, let me just draw that figure so that I can make you understand it a little better. I will draw that beam again. This is the pin support. This is the roller support. This is also the roller support, and this is also the roller support. Here we have hinges. Okay, you should not forget drawing the hinges, otherwise the beam will become indeterminate. This is point A, B, C, and D, right? So this is your 12 meter, 16 meters and 12 meters. Now you can see I have removed the external load, right? Okay, now here I have to apply 1 kilonewton meter moment and 1 kilonewton meter moment. So this is 1 kilonewton meter moment on point B for span AB, and this 1 kilonewton meter moment is at point B for span BC. Are you clear, students? Is that okay? Yes or no? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Now this is your real beam. This is the real beam. And now you have to draw the conjugate beam for this, right? So since these are the hinges, okay, these two are the hinges, I know that both all the span AB, BC and CD, all of them will act independently as if they are the independent simply supported beams. So let me try to draw them independently. So this is your span AB with the pin support here and the roller support on this side, right? And this is your span BC with the roller support on this side and the roller support on this side. So this is C, B, A, and B. Purposely, I'm not drawing CD because no load is there on that span. So I'm not drawing that. So when you try to draw the bending moment diagram for this, so the bending moment diagrams comes something like this. So since you are applying 1 kN moment, so there will be a moment 1 kN, and since this is a pin support, this will be zero. So this will be the bending moment diagram. I mean to say the M/EI diagram. So this is one. Total moment is 1 divided by EI because it is M/EI. Similarly, here also 1, and at this point it will be 0 because it's a roller support. So this will also be 1/EI. So this is your 12 meters and this is your 16 meters. Are you clear, students, with this figure?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. Now you actually need to find out. You applied the unit moment. So I told you whenever you take moment as redundant, you have to actually find out the slope. So now I need to find out what is the total slope at point B. So for that, you find out what is the slope at point B for span AB and slope at point B for span BC. So in the conjugate beam, what you will find, you have to actually find the reaction at point B. For this reaction and this reaction, both reactions you have to find. So let me mark them. So this reaction also you need to find, and this reaction also you need to find. Okay. Now what I will do, I have to name them, right? What I will do, I will take point B as 1, okay, and I will name point C as 2, right? B as 1 and C as 2. So if that is the case, right, I have to actually, these are actually now called flexibility coefficients. Okay, so what I should write, F, I'm trying to find the slope at 1 because of the applying unit moment at 1. Yes or no? Correct or not? I'm trying to find slope at 1 because of unit moment at 1. So this will be F11, which is nothing but reaction at B on conjugate beam. Reaction at B on conjugate beam. Okay, so let me try to find out that. So this is equal to, so this will have two parts. One is this reaction plus this reaction. So let me try to find out that. Okay. What I will do. Let me first find out this reaction, right? So for that, what I have to take? I will take moment at A equal to 0. Taking clockwise moments as positive. So moment at A for this span I'm doing for this span, right? So I'm taking moment at A equal to 0 because I need to find this reaction. So if I do that, I will call, say, this reaction as say F11 left, okay, and I will call this reaction as F11 right. Okay, when I do that, so F11 left at point A will actually cause an anticlockwise moment. So F11 left into 12 meters, and this UVL at point A will actually cause a clockwise moment. So plus total load is half, base is 12, height is 1/EI. And what will be the CG distance from here to here? It will be 2/3 of 12. Equal to 0. Is it okay, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So if that is the case, I will get F11 left as 4 by EI. Right. Similarly, I will calculate F11 right. To calculate F11 right, I will take moment at C equal to 0. Now for this one, for this beam, taking moment at C equal to 0, taking clockwise moments as positive. So F11 right at point C will actually cause a clockwise moment. So F11 right into 16. And this UVL at point C will actually cause anti-clockwise moment. So minus, the total load is half 16 into 1 by EI. And I want CG distance from here to here. So that is 2/3 of 16 equal to 0. So from this, I can get F11 right as 5.33 by EI. So, but I want actually F11, this total F11, which is actually F11 left plus F11 right. So I can, this is F11 is equal to F11 left is 4 by EI plus 5.33 by EI. So that comes out to be 9.33 by EI. Is that okay, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I need to calculate the slope at point C, right? I need to calculate slope at point C. So what will be its notation? Can anybody tell me? I want to calculate slope at point C.
So
C is actually F12. No. C is 2. See here, I want to calculate slope at point C. Yes, it is. Slope at C is F21, because at 2 I need to calculate the slope, but where I have applied the unit moment? At 1. So it will be F21. So F21 will be, that is nothing but I want to calculate what is the slope at point C. Now you can see here on the corresponding conjugate beam, you have to just find this reaction. That's it. I will mark that. So this is nothing but your F21. Right, so calculate this F21. I can do that easily by applying, okay, for this beam only, let me apply this equilibrium equation, summation of phi equal to 0, taking upward forces as positive. Right, so F11 right, I have already calculated 5.33 by EI, so that is upward, so I will write plus 5.33 by EI. Okay. And minus this uniformly varying load. Minus this total load is half of base is 16 and height is 1 by EI. And this F21 is upward, so I will write plus F21 equal to 0. So from this, you can get the value of F21 as, let me just calculate that. So 0.5 into 16, okay, 8, okay, 5.33 minus 8, it comes minus 2.67. If you take it on that side, it becomes plus. So F21 is 2.67 by EI. Okay. Is that okay? Are you clear in these calculations?
Yes.
Right. Now I had applied, I got two more slope values, right? I want two more slope values. So that I can achieve by applying unit moment at point C on left hand side and on the right hand side. So let me do that also. So what I will do, yeah, let me do that. No issues with that. So which is your next class?
So highway engineering.
Okay, are they taking online or?
Sir, but last week sir didn't take the class.
Okay, let me just continue that and finish off this problem. Is that okay now with everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, now what I will do, instead of applying unit moment at a point B, I will apply unit moment at point C so that I can get two more slope values. So let me just draw that or else I will take this figure only. Okay, 1 kilonewton meter here and 1 kilonewton meter here. Okay, in the same way, I have to draw the conjugate beam also. So the conjugate beam will be only for span BC and span CD. For other spans, it will not come. For span BC and this is for span CD. Roller support. Roller and this is also roller. So this is D, C, C and B. So since 1 kilonewton meter is here, so there will be bending moment diagram, M by EI diagram like this. This is also 1 by EI and here also it will be like this. This is also 1 by EI. So this is your 16 meters and this is your 12 meters. Right? So I need to calculate first let me calculate slope at point B, right? So I should name it as F. At point B, I need to calculate. So I should write here 1. So where I have applied the moment? At 2. So F1, 2, right? Also, I need to calculate the slope at point C. So where I have to calculate slope? At 2. Where I have applied the moment? At 2. So these two values I need to calculate, which are nothing but slope at point B and slope at point C. Let me just mark them. So this will be totally directly F1, 2, right? But here in this case, this will be F2, 2 left and this will be F2, 2 right. Okay, so what I will do, let me just quickly calculate that. So for this one now. So first I want F1, 2. So I will take moment at C equal to 0. Moment at C equal to 0. Taking clockwise moment as positive. So F1, 2 at C will actually cause a clockwise moment. So F1, 2 into 16. And that UVL at point C will cause an anti-clockwise moment. So it is minus half of base is 16 and height is 1 by EI equal to 0. So from this, you will get F1, 2 as 0.5 into 16. So it comes 8. Okay. So 8 divided by 16, you will get 0.5 by EI. F1, 2. No, I made some mistake here. What is that mistake? Can anybody tell me what is the mistake I made? What mistake I have done?
CG.
Yes, correct. Have not taken the CG, right? This multiplied by 1/3, correct? So 1/3 of, because I'm taking moment at C, so 1/3 of 16 equal to 0. So this I'm getting F12 as 2.67. Okay, F12 I got. So let me just calculate F2 left, right? The same, in the same beam. So I will apply summation of Fy equal to 0. Taking clockwise movement, sorry, upward forces as positive. So F12 is upward, so I will take 2.67 divided by EI. And UVL is downward, so I should take minus. Total load is half of base is 16 into 1 by EI equal to 0. So I will get plus, yeah, it is plus F22 left. So I will get F22 left as 0.5 into 16, so 2.67 minus 8. So if I take it on that side, it becomes 5.33 by EI. I also want F22 right. So for that, I will take moment at D equal to 0 for this beam now. Taking clockwise movements as positive. So F22 right at point D will cause a clockwise movement. So F22 right into 12, and this UVL at point D will actually cause a anti-clockwise movement. So half of base is 12 and height is 1 by EI, and the CG distance, that is 2/3 of 12. Okay, this equal to 0. So let me just calculate that, how much I will get. 0.5 into 12 into 2/3 into 12, right? So 48, if I take it on that side, 48 divided by 12, right? 4 by EI. F22 right, I'm getting 4 by EI. But total F22 is F22 right plus F22 left. So this comes out to be 9.33 by EI. Are you okay, students? Are you clear with these calculations?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now let me quickly form that flexibility matrix equation. So that flexibility matrix equation is F times R equal to delta minus delta naught, right? So what will be the size of this flexibility matrix? So it will be actually 2 by 2. Why it will be 2 by 2? Because it is nothing but the number of redundants, right? Or the statical degree of statical indeterminacy. Degree of statical indeterminacy is 2, and you have chosen 2 redundants. So this flexibility matrix will be having a size of 2 by 2. And what will be the size of this redundant matrix? So it will be 2 by 1, that is 2 rows and 1 column, and this also will be 2 by 1, right? So this is F11, F12, F21, F22. What are my redundants? I have taken moment at B and moment at C. Students, one more thing, the sequence of writing should be same, because B point you have taken 1 and C you have taken 2. So you should write MB and MC. If you write MC and MB, all your answers will go wrong. Okay, so actually this is not delta, this is theta, because we have not found the deflections, we have found the slopes. So theta. So there is no settlement, or I can say there is no rotation which is there already. So this is 0 minus theta b naught, which we have already found. This is also 0 minus theta c naught, which we have already found. So let me just put the values here which we already found. I will take 1 by ei common. This is 9.33, 2.67, 2.67, and 9.33. This MB and MC we don't know. That only we have to find equal to minus theta B naught I have already found. How much was that? Let me just check. Yeah, 4560 by A. What I will take? 1 by EI common also. I will take here also. I will take common. And theta C naught, we have already found. Yeah, it is 2640 by EI. Okay, now you know how to proceed further to find MB and MC. You put them in a simultaneous equation form and you can get the value of MB and MC. Or you can take this matrix on the right hand side, make it inverse, and you can cross multiply the two matrices and you can get the value of MB and MC. So I will not do that part here. I will give you directly the values of MB and MC. So MB, I'm getting minus 426.8. kilonewton meter, and MC I'm getting minus 146.5. You please, I request everyone to please cross check these answers. Okay, I have a little doubt on these answers. Please cross check them, right? Because I made some mistake in the notes. Okay, whatever value I got, I have written there, but I have made some mistake. So I want everyone to please cross check these answers. Is that clear, students? All these calculations? Are you clear? Any doubts?
Sir?
Yes.
So when you applied moment, sir, at B and C, so then that M by EI diagram, so it says 1 by EI. You should not multiply distance there, sir.
No. See, so you already applied the moment, right? For example, I will tell you forget about whatever numerical example I have solved, right? I will take one simple beam. Let me take one simple beam. Okay, let it be a simply supported beam, a pin support here and a roller support here. Let this distance be say 10 meters, okay? And the load on this beam is, we have a 1 kilonewton meter load which is acting at point B. Now how will be your bending moment diagram? So your bending moment diagram will be something like this, no? Since point A is a pin support, the bending moment will be 0. At point B also, there should be bending moment 0, but we have already applied 1 kilonewton meter. So that bending moment will come here. So how will you join from here to here? It is like this. So the bending moment value here will be 1. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If you are not convinced with that, what you do, you go back and calculate these reactions. Okay. You calculate these reactions and draw the bending moment diagram. Then you will understand why you're getting such kind of a bending moment diagram. Are you clear? Yeah.
Yes,
any other doubts are there in this? See, whenever you apply the moment as the redundant, so these kind of shapes you will get always. Remember. I will take one more numerical example, not now. Maybe in next class, I will take one more numerical example wherein what I will do, I will make a combination. Like I will take few as a reaction as a redundant and few as a moment as a redundant, and I will combine and I will show you how you can do that kind of numerical examples also. But what I suggest you is you study both types of redundant, right? Like how by taking reaction as the redundant, how to solve, and by taking moment as the redundant, how to solve. Because in most of the numerical examples in question papers, he may ask you, he may specify, okay, analyze this beam using flexibility matrix method, full stop, take reaction as the redundant, or he can tell you take moment as the redundant. So like that he can specify. So I suggest you people to study both types, like taking reaction as the redundant and by taking moment as the redundant. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what we will do now, let me quickly check whether this numerical example, whatever we have solved, is correct or not. I will do that in my software. Let me just wait for a minute. Okay, is this screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me draw that beam here. Let me take it from this side. So this side, it is actually 12 meters. So what I will do, I will change the scale. Let me take 50 by 50. This will be too much. Let me change the scale, 100 by 100. Let me take it 100 by 100 paper size. Okay. Okay. Then this side, it is from here. Yeah, from here it is actually 16 meters. Okay. And from here, it is again 12 meters. Yes, okay. Now I will apply the supports. Here we have a pinned support. And at all other points, I have a roller support. Here, here, and here. And what about loads? I will take the loads. Here I have 40 kilonewton meter on this span from here to here. It should be distributed. 40, run it from here to here. Okay. And here at 12 meters, I have a 120 kilonewton. 120 kilonewtons at 4 meters. 2.5 it is, and here it is 4. Okay. Then from here to here, go to loads. Distributed, here I have 20 from here to here. Distributed 20 from here to here. Right, done. So solve. You can check your answers whether they are correct or not, right? You can draw the diagrams also, that is bending moment diagram. Let me draw that. See, it is 443 I'm getting here, moment at B, I'm getting 426. That's what I told you. there is something wrong in that. So here you are actually getting 443, but I'm getting 426. And here you're getting 156, but I'm getting 146. So a little change is there. So that only you have to just cross check and do that. So this is how, friends, you can cross check your answers, right? Okay, any issues? Shall I close the meeting if no doubts are there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.